Hello and welcome everyone. Today we are going to look at the solution of the challenge that we shared last week. At the beginning, let's start by a quick reminder of the challenge itself. The challenge was quite simple. On the left hand side, we have a table containing a price list of only one product. You can notice that the start date was 1st of January. The price was 500. On 15th of March, we have an update to 515. And on 15th of April, we have another update to 520. What we need to do using Power Query is to split the date column into two columns. As you can see in this table, I have a start date and then end date. The end date of each period is exactly one day before the start date of the next period. So you can notice here 14th of March and then 15th of March, up to 14th of April and then 15th of April up to 22nd of November. For sure, the end date of the current price should be today's date, as you can notice here, 26 November 22nd. When we have new prices updating the table, like what we have here, Control C and Control V, right click and refresh, everything will be updated automatically. A basic assumption here that the input dates should be sorted. In the challenge video I posted last week, I had a mistake. I put this date as 11th of August 20. It should be 11th August 22nd, because as I told you, the assumption is that these dates are sorted. Actually, this time I received a bunch of correct solutions. Most of them were accurate. However, my only comment that some of them were a bit long. In the solution that we are going to present today, you will notice that few steps and we reach a very good result. Let's have a look together. I already loaded the table into Power Query and I have only two steps, the source and then the change type. Let's start by thinking what we need to do exactly. What I want to do is to add a new column. In this new column, I'm going to add the dates as well, but in the new column, I'm going to shift each and every date one step up, meaning that I'm going to ignore the first date, and then the second date will be the first date, the third date will be the second date, and so on and so forth. In order to do so, I need some reference to help me to know where exactly the first date and the second date, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to add column. This column will be an index column, and the index column is going to start from 1. Why I choose to start from 1? Because you know that the Power Query is zero based, meaning that if I want to reference the first row, I need to start by 0. To reference the second row, I need 1. To reference the third row, I need 2. In my case, I'm going to start from the second row, so I'm going to start my index from 1 and then 2 and then 3 and so on and so forth. Next, I'm going to add the new column for the end date. So I'm going again to the add column, and on the left hand side, I'm going to choose custom column and I'm going to give a name. The name will be basically end date. I'm going to start by just referencing all the values inside the start date column inside the new column. How? I'm going to start by referencing the previous step. You can notice that the previous step is the added index and it has a space in between the two words, meaning that if you want to reference this step inside the new column, you need to start by the hash pound and then double quote and then added index. Which column I want to reference? The column I want to reference is just the start date. So I'm going to double click and then click on OK. And let's check the new column. The new column, each and every line contains a list. And if you check the list, it is nothing but all the values in the start date. What I'm going to do now is to just use the index that I already created in order to determine which value I need to keep inside each and every line of the end date column. In order to do so, I'm going to hit the wheel to the right of this step in order to edit, and I'm going to use the curly bracket in order to determine which value using the index. So I'm going to double click the index column and then close the curly bracket and hit OK. And if you check now, you will notice that the second date becomes the first date of the end date column. The third date becomes the second date of the end date column. And we have an error because we don't have fourth date inside the start date column. No problem. I'll keep the error for the moment and I'm going to handle later. The very next step is to just deduct 1 day from each and every value inside the end date column. Why? Because each and every end date should be 1 day before the next start date. I'm going to edit once more, and this time I'm going to use a function called dates.addDay, and I'm going to start with it just after the equal sign. So I'm going to type date.addDays and then open a bracket, and at the end I'm going to add a comma and then minus one, and this will tell Power Query, please deduct 1 day from each value date that you have inside this column, and then click on OK, and here you go, from 1st of January up to 14th of March, from 15th of March up to 14th of April, and the last start date, 15th of April, has an error in the end date, and we are going to handle this error shortly using try and otherwise. We already explained try and otherwise in the previous video. You will find a link to this video on top of the screen right now in case you want to check it back. In order to handle this error, we are going to use try and otherwise. And please think about try and otherwise exactly the same way as the if error function works inside the normal Excel formulas. The action is just check a certain formula or code. If it returns error, please do another action or another formula. So in order to use try and otherwise, I'm going to edit the same step and I'm going to take a new line. So I'm going to just press enter before this code and I'm going to type try, T-R-Y. You will notice it's written in blue, meaning that it is a known keyword by Power Query. And I'm telling Power Query, please try this code. If it comes with an error, please do different code or do different action. In order to tell Power Query what is different action, I'm going to add another line and type otherwise. Then I'm going to add the alternative action. In this case, if the last date is an error, meaning that I need to input today's date. And in order to add a today's date, I'm going to use a function called DateTime.LocalNow. So I'm going to type DateTime.Local, and here is my first choice, date, time, and local now, and then I'm going to open and close a bracket and hit OK. And here you go, instead of the error, we got today's day, but it comes with the time as well. I need only the portion of the date, so I'm going to edit once more. And before the date.time local now, I'm going to add another function called date.from. Open and close a bracket at the end, and then click on OK. And here you go, I have only the date, as you can see. I think I'm ready now. I just need to get rid of the additional columns. So I'm going to start by the start date and then end date and finally the price. Right click and remove other columns. I'm ready to load, home, close and load two. I'm going to select existing worksheet and column E and click on OK. And here you go. I just need to change the date format. I'm going to just copy it from here. And I think it's working perfectly from 1st of Jan up to 14th of March. And then 15th of March up to 14th of April. And from 15th of April up to today, I can just try to add the new dates. Control C and Control V. Right click and refresh. And all is updated perfectly. No problem at all. We managed to split the single date into start and end dates, as you can see. And we have only four steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, just four steps after the source step, and all is sorted out. Last but not least, a very special thank you for each and everyone participated in this challenge. Fathi Taha, Roy Wilson, Shihab Sagir, Alejandro Simon, Osman Ali Altamash, Ashraf Hawash, Ahmed Sayed, Adriel DS, Ibrahim Uzadid, and Abdullah Mashal. Thank you very much for your time. See you in next video and bye.